Hello everyone and welcome back. Lockdown days have made our life so struggling, but just remember that it's for our safety. People today wonder if there is a safe place to raise children or just to stay safe. Yes, there is, and the safest place is our home. So always stay at home. Today is a special day. We are celebrating birthday of a special guy at my home. Meet him. This is our pet fish. He is with me since 4.5 years now, and it's like a deep attachment with him. I wanted to have a pet when I was alone at home all the day when my husband went for job. So I thought of having a fish which is more easy to be grown and kept. And when Nino was born, he became Nino's good friend as if he was mine. I was propagating few mint plants and it came out really well. I think previously I was doing a wrong method. Now it's become a success. Key point is that you have to cut the mint plant just below where the leaf lets are coming, and it is a perfect area where the roots will sprout out. Place these stems in a glass of water and the stem will take root within a couple of weeks, and just transfer it into soil. And these good roots are here, you can see it now. It's very difficult for the kids, especially toddlers, to stay at home. All they want is to just go out and play. And it's been months now. Nino has gone out to parks or to her friends. So it is also boring for them like us. So I make her do little things which make her feel good at home also. She will not get bored. So I make her water the plants, just take care of her baby fish and the other fish. So such small things make her busy all the day. Going to the iftar preparations. After fasting for 1 week, I don't know how many of you feel that craving of having something spicy. So I thought of making a spicy fish curry with the head of a big fish. So it's Kerala fish head curry, which is very famous. We call it Meen Thala curry. For this, I am adding julienne of ginger and garlic into coconut oil, sauteing it well, then adding 3 to 4 green chilies. Now I am going to add 1 sliced onion. After sorting it well, I'm going to add like 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder. Now saute well. Now add in the remaining masalas. Here goes almost 2 tablespoons of red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of Kashmiri red chili powder, 1 mix well until it forms a clump, then add the tamarind paste. Mix well until the raw smell of the masalas goes. Now I am adjusting the consistency with remaining tamarind water. You don't have to make this curry too loose because it's a kind of thick gravy. Now it's about to boil. I'm going to add the fish head. This fish head curry is also a specialty of Toddy Shop. Now I'm adding an extra piece also. Nino cannot eat this head piece, so that's for her. Cover it and cook it for 10 minutes. The little hands are reaching everywhere, just making her busy. The problem is that sometimes she want to master it and I should be her assistant. Since we all have fasting, it doesn't limit me from making good food for Nainu. I make her side dishes which can be taken as such or with a rice or porridge. Today I have taken some of the string beans and cut it into 2-inch pieces. Now add enough water and cook along with turmeric and salt. Just a mini version of avial. It is cooked. I am adding the paste of coconut, shallots and jeera, the usual avial mix, and cook it. Another option for kids at home which is very healthy is sprouted moong dal porridge. Just adding moong dal sprouted to porridge along with few protein pieces, that is fish or meat, can go very well. Now I'm preparing an easy iftar snack, a kind of cake-like snack. For this, I'm adding 2 eggs into a blender. Now to this I am adding 1 cup of milk and half a cup of oil. You can use vegetable oil. Then goes in 1 teaspoon of pepper powder and 1 teaspoon of oregano. The oregano's flavor make it really tasty. And then goes in 1/4 cup of maida or all-purpose flour, blend it together along with some salt. Now add 1 teaspoon of fenugreek powder. This gives the actual flavor for fish curries. Add in 1 tomato sliced along with curry leaves. Then just cook it for 5 more minutes. Now let's prepare the filling. For this, to a pan I am adding oil. Then goes in almost 1.5 onion chopped. Saute well. Now you can switch off the flame. The curry is almost ready. If you want it more thick, you can boil it for some more time. Now add 1 teaspoon of ginger and 1 teaspoon of garlic to the masala. Now add in 1 tomato, then goes in 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1 tin of tuna. Instead of red chili powder, you can add fish masala powder also. Then goes in the coriander leaves. And the masala is ready. You can add pepper if you wish. Now I am keeping a frame under the pan to reduce heat and to keep a uniform heat. Now to the same pan I am adding 1 teaspoon of ghee and spread it all around. Now pouring the batter half. Now place the masala evenly at the center. Now pour the remaining batter above this. I am switching off my flame, my curry is thick. Just adding some masalas above as a garnish. Now I am placing few slices of yellow capsicum. It's just optional, but I love the taste. Garnish it with few coriander leaves and cover and cook on one side for 5 minutes. Now I am just going to prepare a fruits cup. For this I am taking almost a handful of cornflakes, layering it in a glass. Above this I am making a sauce with 1 cup of curd and almost 2 teaspoons of honey. You can balance the sweetness according to your taste. Mix it well. You have to layer this curd mixture above the cornflakes and then goes in the fruits. I'm not doing it right now because the crispness will be lost. Just keeping it ready. You can add fruit of your choice. I have taken some kiwis, oranges, pears, plums and all. Now I'm going to prepare an immune booster, a drink. So I have taken 2 lime. You can peel off the skin if you don't like a bitter taste to your lime. To this I'm going to add 1 inch long ginger piece. Now goes in sugar and handful of mint leaves along with water. So my pola is ready now. Now our immune booster is also ready. You have to prepare it just 5 minutes before iftar, otherwise it will turn bitter. Now I am adding the curd mixture above the cornflakes. You can layer it in your own way. I had few sabja seeds or basil seeds, so I have soaked it already. I am adding that too also. And above this goes the fruit mixture. It's really tasty to have it all together, just for a change. Thank you. So that's all for today. Simple and humble. I hope you all enjoyed this video. See you in the next episode. Till then, take care and bye-bye.